What's up, guys? Ricky Boada here. We have this 1977 Corvette C3. This one's a little bit different because it's got the front end and the rear end from a 1981, 82 Corvette. Makes it look a little bit different, but I'm here to tell you why you should probably get one of these right now. So I picked up this 1977 for $5,000. Depending on the viewer, that may be a lot, that may be a little, but for this particular car, it's definitely a bargain. It's the type of car that you pull up to the gas station and everyone's gonna look at you. Everyone wants to take pictures with the car, and it's definitely got a cool factor, low, sleek. It's not something you see every day. Woo! Oof. The 77 is supposed to bring this bumper back here that has these like bumperettes. With the upgraded early 80s front and rear, makes it completely sleek. Other cool factors about this car, this is where you pump gas. That's pretty cool. Something that makes a big impact on this car, and it's not for everybody, is the lowering links. So this car got lowered about 4 inches. As you can tell, there's no huge gap here. The car is really supposed to sit about that high. Once you lower it, I mean, it sits so low to the ground. Only bad thing is the belly of this car kind of hangs down, so you're really close to the ground. You got to drive a little bit careful, but it definitely gives it a nice sleek look that, again, for $5,000, it's a bargain. Woo! Oof. So when this car got designed in the late 60s, ran throughout the whole entire 70s, the whole thing was looking sleek, looking cool. The 70s was all about the coolness. This is how you open this door. You go here, boom, and you squeeze. That's cool. So the whole front end of this car really ties in together with the upgraded and facelifted front end. This car is really supposed to have, again, these bumperettes up here, kind of like a weird front nose. This whole entire piece changes. This all changes and it all really ties together. One big thing to look for when you're buying this car is that the headlights actually work. Since they're vacuum lines and they work off the vacuum of the engine, a lot of these lines get cracked. They get old, so when you pull the switch, maybe one of them comes up, maybe they're like and there's a leak and they just won't work. So that's something to look out for. Luckily, for $5,000, these lights still work. So on a cool day like today, maybe at nighttime, you want to let the wind blow in your hair, just take the T-tops off. Really easy. There's handle here, boom, boom. Easy as that. You can go back here, and they easily just fit, bam, in there. Now I'm gonna go inside, show you guys the interior. So we'll talk about the good parts of this car. The interior is extremely cheap to redo. So these seats, they look brand new. This car wasn't even a black interior car. It was a brown interior car. Switched everything up to black interior for like 700 bucks. You can't beat that. If you're gonna try and take a long drive, your back is still gonna hurt. They don't have the proper support. Another thing. Steering wheel kind of sits offset, and I've driven a few of these other ones and it's just the way that it is. It's kind of weird. In an old car like this, the gauges sometimes are gonna work, sometimes they're not. This one in particular is automatic, as you can tell. The other one is 4-speed, which I think would probably be cooler, but this is more of a, you know, you're gonna chill and relax. Here we have something extremely cool. So this is actually the exhaust cutout. You can open up the valves so that it can be quiet, or just open header, and then that's fucking dope. Something that a lot of people don't know when driving this car, so you turn it on, and then when you turn it off, people just try and remove the key here. There's actually a key lockout, which is right here, lets you finish taking off the key completely. AC controls are pretty standard. A lot of these brought AC, a lot of them don't work. For $5,000, can't expect much. This one doesn't. Something that you're gonna notice that's actually pretty impressive as soon as you get in this car are the wheel arches. Cause you're sitting down here so low to the ground and all you see is, well, the cowl right here and then both wheel arches that are sticking up. As you're driving, that looks extremely sick. Something to look out for in these cars. Remember, this is fiberglass body. So there's gonna be a bunch of spots that get really ugly and don't really match up well with the rest of the car and they get deteriorated. This is probably one of the spots up here is another one of the spots. This car is what they have, what it's called a bird cage, which is actually like the metal frame that holds everything together. Those things rust a lot. So as you're looking at the car and you're like, oh yeah, cool, it's got no rust, because you're pressing over here, you know, you're checking all this and it doesn't have any rust because it's fiberglass, make sure to really look into the parts that could have rust, because they probably do. I almost forgot something that drove me crazy. I couldn't find the battery on this car. Battery is back here in there in a little box. All right, let's get out of here. Let's go for a spin. Should we do that? Open up the exhaust. Makes all the difference in the world. Let's roll. So if you're in the market for one of these and you want a fun car, actually this doesn't drive too great, but they're cheap, they're reliable. I mean, you still have a Chevy 350, you're gonna find parts everywhere. It's a bargain, man. They're only gonna go up in value. Make sure you're getting a good deal, getting a good car, and you can't go wrong. If you like these videos, make sure you like, subscribe, and just write us a little comment. Keeps us motivated, keeps us wanting to do more. Peace.